I grew up with posters of American Ballet Theater dancers on my walls in North Carolina. So to think that I now lead this company alongside our artistic director and have the opportunity to advance and propel the careers of our incredibly talented artists and staff, I just feel so blessed. There's one area I think where ABT and all of ballet, frankly, has not elevated women in leadership roles, and that's as choreographers, as the people who are telling the stories. Yeah. And you see a similar challenge in film where there aren't enough female directors
or
theater where there aren't enough female playwrights, right? The stories are being acted by and performed by incredible artists who are women, but the storytellers haven't always been women.
Yeah.
And so we at ABT decided several years ago in 2016, 2017 to launch the ABT Women's Movement to address this historical imbalance. So just to give you a few numbers, the Data Dance Project reports that even in the past season, so 2019, 2020, pre-pandemic, 72% of the works that were premiered by the top 50 companies or presented by the top 50 dance companies in the US were by men.
Wow.
Right? So we know that all of these companies have more women than men in the ranks, but yet the stories are being told by the people being commissioned, who are the choreographers, the leader in the front of the room are men. Sure. And so with the ABT Women's Movement, we committed to commissioning and staging works by women. Yeah. And since 2017, we have commissioned and staged 27 works by amazing women who now have these opportunities to work with the best dancers in the country and to have access to our audience and for our audience to be able to enjoy and experience the stories that these women are telling. I think that one thing that I loved about my Tri-Delta experience was the camaraderie, and the camaraderie across ages and stages. My grandmother, she used to say, she passed away last year, and one of her just lines that she always said was, you have to have a little bit of fun every day. And whenever she would hear me getting too wrapped up in the minutiae and the struggle of leading a company or trying to raise three kids while leading a company, she would say, did you have a little bit of fun today? And I always, when she would say that, I would think about my college experience and what Tri-Delta meant to me, which was not only this warm, hospitable, caring group of women, but also this group of women who said, okay, time to put the books down and let's go hang out, right? Let's enjoy this precious time that we have together.